So now here comes the fourth one by the Professor Yakubenko with the topic indentation of biomaterials with relaxation properties.
Hello, I'm a not professor, I'm a PhD student.
Okay, welcome. Let me start.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Anastasia Kalyanka. I am a PhD student of Moscow Institute of Physics and Technology, and I also work in the Laboratory of Topology of Vyshlinsky Institute for Problems in Mechanics. Today, I will tell you about the work indentation of biomaterials with relaxation properties. This study was carried out along with Garachev and Georgiev. Study of mechanical characteristics of biological tissue is a critical problem. This information is used not only in developing medical equipment, but also in analyzing the state of health. To determine the mechanical properties of soft tissues, the indentation or non-indentation methods are often used in practice. The programs of the experiments can have not only the stage of indentation or loading, but also the stage of holding or unloading stage. Moreover, various shapes of indenter tips are used in the tests. To obtain information about the tissue's properties based on the test results, it is necessary to have the mechanical models of the interaction of the indenters with biomaterials. For this purpose, it needs to solve the contact problems, taking into account the mentioned factors such as the parameters of interaction and the indenter shapes. In this presentation, I formulate the problem statement, the mechanical model of the tissue, and the method of constructing the analytical solution. Then I present the numerical results for particular cases. Also, I consider a simplified one-dimensional model and make the conclusions. So, the interaction of a rigid cylinder with flat base of given radius with a viscoelastic layer of the thickness h, rigid on a laying on a rigid base without friction is considered. Normal force P is applied to the cylinder along the axis Z. The process of interaction has two stages. The first stage is the loading stage with the constant speed, and the second stage is the holding at the definite depth. Because of many materials, biological materials show rheological properties, it is necessary to take into account viscoelastic properties of the material. The material of the layer is assumed to be homogeneous, isotropic, and linear viscoelastic. A basic equation relating displacements and stress in linear viscoelasticity theory has the following form. Here, G1 is the relaxation function in the case of shear, and G2 is the relaxation function in the case of isotropic compression. If the material has a constant Poisson's ratio, the basic equation can be written using only one relaxation function. This case is considered in this work. Boundary conditions of this problem has the following form. In the contact region, we have the displacement, and in the other boundary, we know the stresses. W is normal displacement of the boundary of the layer, P is the contact pressure, and A is the radius of the contact region. For flat-ended indenter, the contact region is a constant, and in our case, it is equal to the radius of the cylinder. So the type of boundary conditions remains unchanged throughout the process. Therefore, it is possible to use the Volterra principle. According to this principle, to solve the viscoelastic contact problem, it needs to replace the elastic constants of the corresponding elastic problem with the integral operators. Those for the contact pressure and the applied load, we can write the following expressions where Q is the solution of the elastic problem and G is the relaxation function corresponding to the uniaxial tension or compression. In the elastic case, the vertical displacement of the layer boundary are related to the contact pressure as follows. E is the elastic modulus, mu is the Poisson's ratio, and G is Bessel function of the first kind. Inside the contact region, where W is known, we have an integral equation for the contact pressure. To solve this equation, we can use approximation methods of large and small lambda. Lambda is the parameter which is equal to the ratio of the layer thickness and the cylinder radius. These methods are described in detail in the work of scientists Varovich and Alexandrov. Using known elastic solutions and replacing the elastic modulus with the relaxation function, we can obtain the solution of the contact problem under consideration. In the case of thick layer, when the values of lambda are more than one, the expressions for the contact pressure and for the applied load are presented here. In the right part of the slide, it is presented the results for the case of thin layer when the values of lambda are less than one. Now, let's consider one viscoelastic model, namely standard linear viscoelastic solid. The relaxation function for this model has the following form. It has three parameters. E is the long-term Young modulus, alpha and beta are expressed through the relaxation time and the creep time. Using the expression for the indentation depth delta and for the relaxation function, we get the solution for the thick layer and the thin layer, which is presented here. As can be seen from the expression for the contact pressure and the applied load, the dependence of these values on time is expressed via function T1, which is the same for the thick layer and the thin layer, and it depends only on the type of relaxation function and the program of loading. This slide shows the contact pressure distribution at different depth of indentation during the loading stage for thick and thin layer. Dots on the graphs correspond to the case of the elastic layer with the viscoelastic coefficient T, which is equal to the ratio of the creep and relaxation times, is equal to 1. As follows from the results, a decrease in the layer thickness leads to the equalization of the pressure in the central of the contact region. We can also see that at the same depth, the pressure for viscoelastic layer is higher than for elastic layer, because the line is on all graphs is higher than the dots. And during the holding stage, as the results show, the pressure at each point of the surface decreases and over time tends to the value of the elastic layer with a long-term elastic modulus. This slide presents study of the applied load depends on time for different values of the indentation speed V, this graph, and for different values of the viscoelastic coefficient T, this graph. As follows from the first graph, with an increase in the speed leads to an increase with the applied load at the fixed depth. only during the loading stage. An increase in the viscoelastic coefficient T also leads to the same results, as we can see from this graph. And also during the holding stage, this part of the graph, that solution tends to the value corresponding to the elastic layer with the long-term elastic modulus E. Now we consider one more viscoelastic model, power law rheology model. The relaxation function for this model presented here, it has now four parameters. E is the long-term elastic modulus. Also we have parameter A, theta, and degree parameter gamma. When gamma is equal to zero is the elastic case. Using this relaxation function and the expression for indentation depth, we get the solution for the thick layer and the thin layer. Also, the time dependency of these functions is expressed through the function T2 as for the standard linear viscoelastic body. As we can see, the dependence on the coordinate R is the same because it will be the same for all viscoelastic models. So we analyze only the time dependence of the applied load. The first graph is the dependence of the applied load on time for different values of the parameter A. As we can see, an increase in this coefficient leads to an increase in the load at the fixed depth. This graph is constructed for different values of the degree parameter gamma. The value of the parameter gamma significantly affects the rate of the load growth in the loading stage and the relaxation rate of the load at the holding stage. During the holding stage, also the solution tends to the values S for elastic layer with a long-term elastic modulus E. So the results from the holding stage can be used to determine the parameters of the viscoelastic model. To describe the mechanical behavior of viscoelastic materials, it is also possible to use different one-dimensional models. Basic equation for example, for standard viscoelastic models had the following form. It has also three parameters, long-term elastic modulus, creep time, and relaxation time. The spring damper representation of this model is shown here. For this model, we consider two forms of cylinder base, is the flat base and the spherical base with the given curvature radius. By solving this differential equation and taking into account the initial conditions, we get the following results for the contact pressure for both forms, for the flat base and for the spherical base. Using the equilibrium conditions for the cylinder and integrating the contact pressure over the contact area, we get the following expressions of the applied load for both forms. For the spherical base, we have three parts because the process will consist of three stages. Penetrating stage with changing contact area, penetrating with a constant contact area when corner points are in the contact with the layer, and the holding stage. For the flat cylinder base, we can compare results with results obtained for continuous model, which were obtained earlier on these graphs, dots correspond to the results for the simplified one-dimensional model. The first graph presents the contact pressure distribution on the cylinder surface at the fixed depth, but for different value of the layer thickness. As you can see here, we can see that simplified model cannot be used to study the pressure distribution because in this case, the contact pressure does not depend on the coordinate and will be constant under all surface of the cylinder. But however, the simplified model gives good results for the dependence of the applied load on time. As follows from this graph, the dependence is close to the case of the applied load obtained by using the continuous model, especially for small layer thickness. The red line and the red dots here. This slide presents the results for the spherical cylinder base. The first graph is the contact pressures at different values of the depth. In this case, the contact pressure distribution has a parabolic form, and at the stage with changing contact area, the pressure is equal to zero at the border of the contact region. The second graph is the dependence of the applied load on time for different values of the curvature radius of the spherical base. As we can see, at the fixed depth, the load applied to the cylinder with spherical base is less than to the cylinder with flat base. And with an increase of the curvature radius of the base, the applied load increases and tends to the value of the load applied to the cylinder with flat base, the black line on this graph. Thus, the developed model can be used to study the complex process of interaction of rigid cylinder with a viscoelastic layer lying on a rigid base without friction. Obtained analytical results allows to analyze the influence of the indentation speed, the viscoelastic properties of the layer and its thickness on the contact pressure distribution and the applied load. Considering the one-dimensional model and comparing the results with the case of a continuous model, allows us to determine cases when it is more appropriate to use simplified models to describe the mechanical behavior of the layer. Thank you for your attention and good health for all of us.
Thank you, Professor Yakubenko. Okay. Is there any question?
There are, my question is that problems with adaptation is usually used to any problem of indentation. It's usually used to obtain properties of material, elastic, viscoelastic properties.
Yes.
And you showed us different models. Mm-hmm. And what do you think about using these models for this inverse problem?
As we can see, the second model, which is power law rheology model, has a very significant influence on the rate of the growth of the load and of the relaxation. So this model is used for polymers, for example, and if we have a short period of time in the beginning of the process, we can use this model.
Thank you. Mm-hmm.